Hello everyone, this is the Mighty Krug, and I wanted to present a video for the community today. I've been watching a lot of fantastic videos showcasing Chaos Dwarves. Their popularity is definitely on the rise. However, some of the newer folks in the community may not realize that they got their beginnings way back in 1988 with Marauder Miniatures. This company was formed by Ali and Trish Morrison. Everyone knows them from Games Workshop. The company announcement and first official advertisement, I guess, came in White Dwarf 106. Marauder Miniatures ran concurrently with the Citadel line of miniatures that supported the games. There were four sculpts in the initial Chaos Dwarf line designated MM90/1. And I'm fortunate enough to have four raw miniatures from 1988. Yeah, I'm one of those guys. This is old school stuff here. This is so old school, it's like old preschool. This is the Chaos Dwarf Sorcerer. Probably one of my favorite sculpts of all time, even though, you know, it's not filled with tons of detail like some of today's models, but just a great mini. The second model in the series is this fellow with the very distinctive helmet and the giant cleaver. Very imposing and threatening in his piles of scale armor. Another fun little sculpt. The third miniature in the line was the Chaos Dwarf Warrior, with the trademark curved horns meeting and spiky ball over helmet technique that a lot of the old timers will remember is a pretty commonplace trait among many of the Chaos miniatures lines that were running at the time. This fellow's dual wielding some hammers and some mallets, useful for cracking open armor. And last but not least, the two-handed mace, again with the distinctive helmet. Now these miniatures, they look small and funny, I guess, to a lot of new users or new members to the community. These guys are sitting on 20 millimeter bases and like they're fully on it, you know. So it started out as a true 25 millimeter scale, and of course that grew to 28 millimeter and 28 millimeter heroic or 30 millimeter scale. Just by way of comparison, I've got a new model still in the blister pack, or a newer model. This is probably 2004, but maybe you can see just how much bigger this dwarf in the blister pack is. So yeah, they've bulked up quite a bit over the years. And the idea is that if I can find the time, I will attempt to paint these four guys up and display them here on my YouTube channel. I'm trying to transition from painting in my kitchen to having my own workspace. So my man cave is a little disarrayed right now, but we're working on that, and hopefully I'll get that finished up soon and we can put some paint on these guys and see how well they turn out. So yeah, old school Chaos Dwarves for, you know, the new folks to see and the old guys to look back through the window of time and hopefully have a fond memory. And until next time, I'll see you guys later.